This is a Friday Shoes production. Lesson 2-4, found on page 102, and the target is I can divide positive and negative fractions. Get your notes ready. Key concept here is the inverse property of multiplication. What it says is the product of a number and its multiplicative inverse is 1. And they show it to you here. They have 3/4 times its multiplicative inverse, which you might call the flip of the fraction. It's 4/3, that equals 1. So the multiplicative inverse of a number is the number that multiplied by the original number will give you 1. So if you had 3/4, you said, what's the multiplicative inverse? Well, that's this number, because when you multiply it by it, you'll get 1. The product will be 1. Now, you may have heard the word reciprocal. Reciprocal and multiplicative inverse are the same thing. So you can interchange those two words. How do you find a multiplicative inverse, or how do you find a reciprocal? Step one is you're going to convert it to a fraction first, then flip it. So that's what it says here. To find a multiplicative inverse or reciprocal of a number, convert it to a fraction, then flip it. So let's take a look at this number here. So we have -5 2/3. That is not a fraction. I know you're looking at it going, well, there's a little fraction in there, 2/3, but this is called a mixed number. We need to change it to a fraction first, then flip it over. So let's change this to a fraction. Let's see here. I do 5 times 3 there, and then plus the 2. That's going to be 17. That's all over 3, and it's a negative fraction, so I'll put my negative on it. Now flip it over. So now it's going to be -3/17. There is the multiplicative inverse of this number, -5 2/3. And again, what that means is -5 2/3 multiplied by -3/17 will equal 1. If you have a calculator handy, you can try that using your ABC button, see what happens. All right, go ahead and check on your own. See if you understood what I did there. Go ahead and try these on your own. Pause the video, come back, see how you did. All right, first one, -2 1/3, we have to change it to a fraction first. So we take 3 times 2 plus the 1. Ignore the subtraction or the negative sign there for now. So we have 3 times 2 plus 1, which is 7. Put the 3 underneath. Your fraction will always have the same as the fraction bottom. The denominator will always be the same as the fraction bottom in your original number. Mixed number. All right, so let's make sure we have a negative on it. And now we have to flip it over. We're not done yet. That was just changing it to a fraction. Now we have to flip it. So there it is, -3/7. Next one, we have -5/8. This is easy. It's already a fraction. So all we have to do is flip it over. Notice the negative still on it. And what that says, again, if you remember, this is the answer. What that says is -5/8 times -8/5 equals 1, and that is true. Happy check. All right, last one, 7. How do you do that? Well, that's not written as a fraction yet. Write it as a fraction. We all know that a whole number can be written as a fraction by putting a 1 underneath it. Well, we've got a fraction now. Last step is just flip it over. That is our multiplicative inverse. 1/7 is the answer. All right, dividing fractions. To divide by a fraction, we actually multiply by its multiplicative inverse, its flip. So you'll notice in our first example here, or the number section for their symbols, they have 2/5 divided by 3/4. There's the math problem they're trying to do. And they're teaching you, all you do is write the 2/5 and then multiply by the inverse of 3/4, the multiplicative inverse. So the multiplicative inverse of 3/4 is 4/3. If you multiply by the multiplicative inverse, it's the same as dividing by the regular number. We have this thing called KCF, not KFC. That makes me hungry. KCF stands for keep, change, flip. Again, if you look at their problem, the original problem here, when they actually changed it to a multiplication problem, what they did was they kept the 2/5. That's where the K comes from. And then they change the sign from division to multiplication. That's what the change stands for. And then the last one is flip. They flipped the fraction. They took 3/4 and flipped it over to 4/3. Then they did this math problem, 2/5 times 4/3. Take a look at the examples down here. And we've been practicing these in class too, using it in a different version. But here you are. You have two fractions. It says divide right in the simplest form. All right. Well, to divide fractions, you actually are going to multiply by the multiplicative inverse or the reciprocal. So how do we do that? Well, we keep the first fraction. Notice that k. So we're going to keep the first fraction, negative 4/5. Don't do anything with that. We're going to change the sign from the operation from a division to a multiplication. And then we're going to flip the fraction. It already is a fraction, so that's easy. We flip it over. Do that math problem, and it will be the answer to this math problem up here. All right, so how do we do this again? Well, that was last lesson. I see that I'm going to have a 2 that's common between the 4 and the 6. 2 goes into 4 2 times, and 2 goes into 6 3 times. Looks like that's about it. Now, I'm going to take it and multiply across. I'm going to have 2 times 7, that's 14. I'm going to have 5 times 3, that's 15. Now, don't forget, we had a negative fraction times a positive fraction, so the answer is going to be a negative. So I have a negative 14 15ths. There's the final answer. Let's take a look at the second one. These are not written as fractions. Well, we can change them to fractions. Then we can work with KCF. So let's do 3 times 4 plus 2. That's going to be 14 over 3. And we still have divide. And then we have 2 times 3 plus 1. That's going to be 7 over 2. It is a negative fraction, so I'll put a negative on it. Now, let's do the keep, change, flip. So we have the keep, meaning we keep the first fraction the same. We change a division to a multiplication, and we flip the fraction. So now we have negative 2/7 instead of negative 7 over 2. And then we multiply those two. Well, I can reduce first. 7 goes into itself once, and it goes into 14 twice. No top goes into any bottom. No bottom goes into any top. They don't share any common factors. Therefore, we multiply across. 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. And then 3 times 1 is 3. There is our answer. It's negative 4/3. Now, if you want to change it back to a mixed number, what we would do is, how many 3s go into the 4 on top? Well, 1 with 1 left over. And we always put a 3 on the bottom because of this 3. Now, it is a negative fraction, so there we have a negative mixed number. So that's going to be the most correct answer they're going to give. How about you try a couple down here? Try these 3. Come on back, see how you did. All right, we have 3/4 divided by 1/2. Keep 3/4. Change. Flip. Do the math. All right, 2 goes in. I'm reducing here. That's 1. That's 2. 3 times 1 is 3. 2 times 1 is 2. Oops, I said 2, but I didn't write 2. So that's 3 over 2, which is actually 1 1/2. So there's the answer there, 1 1/2. E, keep, negative 1/4, change, flip, 8/7. Reduce if you can. I can. So we have 1 times 2 is 2. We have 1 times 7 is 7. But we had a negative times a positive. I know that's going to be a negative fraction. So it's negative 2/7. Last one here. Again, they're telling you that you can write 12 as 12 over 1. So let's write both these as fractions first. That's going to be negative 3 over 2. Keep our division still. We haven't changed that yet. We're going to convert these to fractions. So that's 12 over 1. Now let's do our keep, change, flip. Keep, negative 3 over 2. Change. And then our flip would be 1 over 12. We can reduce. I see 3. Goes into 12 4 times. Goes into itself once. Nothing else works out. We do 1 times 1 is 1. 2 times 4 is 8. A negative times a positive is a negative. There's our answer right there for negative 1 1/2 divided by 12. Last one here. I learned a little bit here. This is the piece of information I even learned, I think it was 2 days ago when I read this. I said, oh, this is pretty neat. On the left there, it says the real world length, the width of the blue portion of the stars and stripes is 7/13 of the width of the entire flag. Didn't know that. The width of each stripe is 1/13 of the width of the entire flag. 13 colonies That's the importance of the 13 in this story here. So it says, crafts. Lena's class is making flags for the school's International Day celebration. She needs 1 1/6 feet of paper for the blue portion on each flag. If the class has a 21-foot roll of blue paper, that's pretty long, how many flags can she make? Well, we have to cut it up into 1 1/6 feet long. So what we're going to do is end up cutting 21 by 1 1/6. And how many times does that go in there? How many times can we make that happen? So you can see this is what you're doing. You're taking 21 and dividing by 1 1/6. Notice how they convert them to fractions. Then they do the keep, change, flip. They reduce. You can see the red there. And it comes out to be 18. So they can make 18 flags using the 21-foot roll of paper. Why don't you give it a shot here? It says, how many 1.5-inch thick boards are in a stack that is 36 inches tall? Well, 36 inches tall, we got to divide it by 1.5. How many of those fit into 36 inches? So we're going to take 36 inches. We're going to divide it by 1.5. Convert both of them into fractions. Notice I'm not changing that division. We're not doing the keep, change, flip yet. We're just changing these to fractions. So we got 3/2 here. Now let's do the keep, change, flip. Keep, change, flip. Any reduction? Yep, I can see that. 3 goes into itself and 3 goes into 36. I believe that's 12 times. Now it's nice. We have 1s on the bottom. So let's multiply across. 1 times 1 on the bottom. That's going to equal 1 on the bottom. And then 12 times 2 on the top. That's going to give you 24. 24 over 1 is 24. So what would be the answer is we can make 24 1.5-inch thick boards that they need. You can review this video if you like, or you can look at the examples in the book as usual. And there's also those personal tutor videos, online textbook. This has been a Friday Shoes production.